Today's topic is called Your Choice. Sometimes in life we lose things. For example, my car keys in my disorganized purse. There is one thing in life we don't want to ever lose: the Lord. The Lord has been with us since we were a tiny speck in our mother's womb. 1 Chronicles 17:8, "And I have been with thee whithersoever thou hast walked." Sometimes in life we get spoiled. We love it when things go our way, but do we ever stop and thank God? When we don't, sometimes we are brought down to our knees. Then we become very angry toward God. We get to believe that He has forsaken us, turned His back on us, and some even imagine evil in their hearts against God. Then they question God, and eventually they give up on God and replace Him with something else, with some other idol in their life. Then they wallow in self-pity as things become even worse for them. Then they decide to reject Him. Isaiah chapter 66, verse 4. "I also will choose their delusions and will bring their fears upon them, because when I called, none did answer. When I spake, they did not hear, but they did evil before mine eyes and chose that which I delighted not." How can you deny God? That's what I would like to know. Does anybody have just cause to deny God? People can believe that they have. Maybe they lost their house, or maybe their child died. People forget that God lost a son. People forget the pain and agony that Jesus bore so we would have forgiveness of our sins. John 8:37. "I know that ye are Abraham's seed, but ye seek to kill me, because my word hath no place in you?" Ephesians 1:7. "In whom we have redemption through his blood, the forgiveness of sins according to the riches of his grace." Luke 20:17. "What is this then that is written? The stone which the builders rejected, the same is become the head of the corner." People make some of the same comments today that were made before Jesus died. Luke 23:39. "And one of the malefactors which were hanged railed on him, saying, If thou be Christ, save thyself and us." Matthew 27:41-43. "Likewise also the chief priests mocking him with the scribes and elders said, He saved others, himself he cannot save. If he be the king of Israel, let him now come down from the cross, and we will believe him. He trusted in God, let him deliver him now, if he will have him, for he said, I am the Son of God." People still say similar things like that and worse. I used to believe a lie myself. I used to say, why is it a big deal that Jesus died on the cross? God brought him back to life. Did God not see all the torment, torture, and agony his son went through to save us? We tend to believe that God has no feelings. He couldn't possibly care. He lets bad things happen to us. He doesn't come to our aid or prevent the bad things from happening to us. Malachi 3:13-15. "Your words have been stout against me, saith the Lord. Yet ye say, What have we spoken so much against thee? Ye have said, It is in vain to serve God. And what profit is it that we kept his ordinance, and that we have walked mournfully before the Lord of hosts? And now we call the proud happy?" These kinds of thoughts are out of ignorance. Hosea 4:6. "My people are destroyed for lack of knowledge, because thou hast rejected knowledge. I will also reject thee, that thou shalt be no priest to me. Seeing thou hast forgotten the law of thy God, I will also forget thy children." When it comes to God, it is a two-way street. If you deny him, he will deny you. Matthew 13:49-50. "So shall it be at the end of the world, the angels shall come forth and sever the wicked from among the just, and shall cast them into the furnace of fire. There shall be wailing and gnashing of teeth. Song of Solomon 5:6. I opened to my beloved, but my beloved hath withdrawn himself and was gone. My soul faileth when he spake. I sought him, but I could not find him. I called him, but he gave me no answer. Ezekiel 21:16. Go thee one way or other, either on the right or on the left, whithersoever thy face is set. Time is running out. Make a choice. As for me, I will cling to the promises. I hope you will too, for I believe that no one wants to be lost. God is wanting all of his children to come home. He doesn't want any of them to perish or be lost. He's seeking that one sheep out of 99 that's lost, and he's looking for that sheep. He wants to bring that sheep home and place it in the rest of the fold. 1 Peter 1:14-16, verses 18 and 19. As obedient children, not fastening yourselves according to the former lust in your ignorance, but as he which hath called you is holy, so be ye holy in all manner of conversation, because it is written, Be ye holy, for I am holy. For as much as ye know that ye were not redeemed with corruptible things, but with the precious blood of Christ, as a lamb without blemish and without spot. 1 Peter 1:25. But the word of the Lord endureth forever, and this is the word which by the gospel is preached unto you. I'm hoping that you will listen to these words today, and they will bring you closer to God and bring you home to fellowship with him. Dear Lord Jesus, please bless these words that have been given today through you to the people. I believe you want all people to come back to you. I know you realize that all won't choose to do so, but for the ones who are willing to hear and listen and take heed to your counsel, I know you will lead them home. You will find a special place in your heart for them. For it was predetermined that special place was there for them if they should just only become home to you. Please, Lord, lead your people back to you. Give them the victory over bondage. Love them unconditionally, regardless of their choice. In Jesus' name I pray, amen.